Welcome to Physics Hub. Today is 28th April 2019 Sunday and here I am with a new set video. So as you know that we upload a set video on every Sunday and it usually consists of 10 solved problems from different topics of physics. We generally upload the question paper on our Facebook page little earlier so that you can try to solve the questions and match your answers whenever the solutions are uploaded. Now one thing, whenever we upload a video, we distribute it into different relatable playlists. So go through the playlist and you will be able to get videos as per your choice. And keep a track of our community post as well. It will help you to make your base of physics strong. You can check the description section of this video to get useful links. Now without any further delay, let's start today's said video. So this set contains 10 questions from mathematical methods of physics. You can download few suggested books, a PDF version of suggested books from our website. So the first question reads, if a matrix A is given by this and I is a 3 by 3 identity matrix, then the largest eigenvalue of matrix A to the power 4 plus A square minus 2i is. Now first of all, we have to find out the eigenvalues of the parent matrix A. So to find the eigenvalue of this matrix, we did this. This is very trivial thing. And from here, we get the eigenvalues as 0, plus 2 and minus 2. Now to find out the largest eigenvalue of this matrix, what we are doing, we're just putting the lambda values here in this expression. A to the power 4 plus A square minus 2i. Then we got lambda 1 equals to minus 2, lambda 2 equals to 18 and lambda 3 equals to 18 by putting lambda 1 equals to 0, means lambda equals to 0. So in place of A we are putting 0, and in the second case in place of A we are putting 2, and in third case in place of A we are putting minus 2. And we see that the lambda values are lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 for this combined case, A to the power 4 plus A square minus 2i, minus 2, 18 and 18. Therefore, the largest eigenvalues of this required matrix is 18. So, option B is the correct option. Question number 2, consider the real function f of x equal to 1 by x square plus 9. The Taylor expansion of f of x about x equal to 0 converges, and you are given 4 options. So this is given f of x equal to 1 by x square plus 9. So we can take 9 common, so 1 by 9 into 1 plus x square by 9. Now it can be taken upward to the numerator, so 1 by 9 into 1 plus x square by 9 to the power minus 1 is basically looking like a plus b to the power minus 1. So thus the Taylor series of fx is 1 by 9 times the binomial expansion of 1 plus x square by 9 polynomials. Now the binomial series converges, we know that this thing x square by 9 means whenever you expand a plus b to the power minus 1, then the suppose 1 plus x to the power minus 1, then this x must be less than 1. So here in place of x it is x square by 9. So x square by 9 modulus must be less than 1. Therefore mod x square is less than 9. So x minus 3 into mod x plus 3 less than 0. There are now you can see that this is mod value, so x is mod x plus 3 must be greater than 0 always. Therefore this must be negative, so that to make the product of these two things negative, so mod x minus 3 must be less than 0, and we can write from here minus 3 less than x less than 3, and it is matching with option 4. So option 4 is the correct option. Moving to question number 3, if the periodic function f of x equal to cos hyperbolic x plus sin hyperbolic x with minus 1 less than x less than 1 is expanded in Fourier series, and it is found that a3 equals to k into e square minus 1 by e into 1 plus 9 pi square, then the value of k is. So to solve this question, what we are doing, so this is basically f of x equal to this. So writing them in terms of exponentials, we get f of x equal to e to the power x. So we are getting a very simplified expression of fx, that is e to the power x, and the value of x is given in the range minus 1 to plus 1. Now we know the formula of Fourier series coefficients, a n equals to 1 by l. So basically the total range is 2l, so 2l is given to be equal to 2, because minus 1 to plus 1 means the range is 2. Okay, This is minus 1, this is 0, this is plus 1, so total is 2. So 2L equals to 2 means L equals to 1. Therefore, the Fourier series coefficient A n equals to 1 by L minus L to L f of x cos n pi x by L dx. So to make it very convenient for you, I have just written the formula. So this replaces the value of L here. So 1 by A 1 minus 1 to 1 e to the power x cos n pi x by 1 into dx. Now we have to use partial integration. And we are getting these terms. Now look here, repetition, e to the power x cos n pi x dx, and we are also finding e to the power x cos n pi x. So this term will come to the left side, and we can take common one. So this term into 1 plus, then when it will go to the left hand side, it will be plus, so 1 by n square plus pi square. So this is after taking common. So try to understand this calculation. So e to the power x by 1 plus n square pi square, and cos n pi x plus n pi sin n pi x. E to the power x we have taken common, and the limit is minus 1 to 1. Remember, this limit is over this whole region, okay, minus 1 to 1. Now putting the limits, we found that n equals to cos n pi by 1 plus n square into pi square into e minus 1 by e. So cos n pi can be written as minus 1 to the power n, and this is e square minus 1 by e into 1 plus n square plus in 1 plus n square into pi square. So you are given this thing, a3 equals to k into this. Now a3 means n equals to 3. So when you put n equals to 3, we get minus 1 to the power 3 means minus 1. So if n equals to 3, they have written k, so k will be minus 1. So that's what it asks you to find out. So basically the value of k is minus 1. So option 2 is the correct option for question number 3. Next, question number 4. Consider the matrix equation. This, the condition for existence of a non-trivial solution is, we know that the matrix A into X equals to 0, where A is a given matrix and X is a column matrix, has a non-zero solution if and only if this mod A equals to 0, means the what is that is called, determinant of that matrix is must be 0. So by equating it to 0 and expanding, we see this to be equals to 0, and it is matching with option 4. So option 4 is the correct option. Let question number 5, let y equals to y of t be the solution to the differential equation y double prime minus 8y prime plus 16y equals to 32t, subjected to the initial conditions y of 0 equals to 1 and y prime at 0 equals to 2, then the value of y at half is. So this is the given differential equation. So the homogeneous part is y double prime minus 8y prime plus 16y equals to 0. Homogeneous means the right hand side we have to put a 0, and these are the initial conditions given. So the auxiliary equation is m square minus 8m plus 16 equals to 0, means m equals to 4. And so the particular integral can be written as 1 by d minus 4 whole square from here. So d square minus 8d plus 16 equals to 1 by d minus 4 whole square, and it is operating on 32t. So 1 by 16, so we are taking 4 common here, so 4 square, so 1 by 16, and 1 minus 4, we are taking minus 4 common, so 1 minus d by 4, and this minus 2 will, this 2 will go to the numerator and become minus 2. So it's basically 1 minus 6 to the power minus n. So just expand. So here there is a minus 1 minus sign, and there is also minus n. So all the terms in the expansion will be positive. So 1 by 16 into 1 plus half d, means d by 4 into 2. So half d plus dot 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 into 32t. Now t has power only 1. So after one derivative, it will become 0. So that's why we have not taken too much term, we have just taken two more terms, and that is enough. So 1 by 16 into 32t means 2t, and plus half means 1 by 32, and d of 32t means 32, because derivative with respect to t, d dt into t equals to 1, so basically equals to 1. So y of t means solution from this part and this particular integral. So c1 plus c2 t, it is of 4t. There is repetition of roots, so c1 plus c2 t, it is equal to 4t plus 2t plus 1. Now this is general solution. Now what we have to do, we have to employ the boundary conditions or the initial condition which have been provided in the question. So y at x equal to or at t equals to 0 equals to 1. So putting that, we are getting the one constant c1 equals to 0, and putting and taking derivative y prime of t to use the second initial condition y prime equals to 2 at t equals to 0. So we see that c2 equals also equals to 0. Therefore, the general solution becomes yt equals to 2t plus 1. Now we have to find out the value of y at t equals to half. Therefore, y at half equals to 2 into half plus 1 equals to 2. So it is matching with option 2. Option 2 is the correct option. Moving to question number 6. If the Fourier series of a periodic function f of x equal to 1 plus x cube, where minus 1 less than x less than 1 is written as f of x equals to this, then which of the following option is correct? So the function f of x equal to 1 plus x cube, so in the range minus 1 to plus 1. So what we are doing, we are just trying to divide it into, we are trying to write it in terms of two, summation of two functions, so that our calculation becomes very easy. So f of x, so we are writing at g of x plus h of x. So g of x equals to 1 and h of x equals to x cube. Now g of x is a constant function, therefore a0 will be equals to 1, a1 an equals to 0 and bn is also equals to 0. Over the interval, x cube is an odd function, hence a0 will be 0 and an equals to 0. We cannot tell the value of bn unless we actually calculate it. Thus, the value of a0 for f of x equal to 1 plus x cube is 1 plus 0 is equal to 1, and the value of a1 square plus a2 square plus a cube square dot dot equals to 0, because these a terms are 0. So the sum of this square is 0. So firstly, this option 2 is discarded. Now the average value of the square of 1 plus x cube over minus 1 to 1. Why you are taking average will be clear in the latter section. So 1 by b minus a means b is here 1 and minus, and a is minus 1. So this is the range a to b. So the average formula for average, 1 by b minus a integration over a to b fx dx, fx whole square dx. Okay, so here fx is 1 plus x cube, so square to dx, because you are taking the square of the average. Okay, so just expand it and taking the integration in the range minus 1 to 1, we are getting average value. Now for this problem, we are applying possible theorem. So from possible theorem, we now know that the square of the average, or average of the square, average value of the square is equals to a0 square plus half into n runs from 1 to infinity an square plus bn square. Okay, so this is 8 by 7, a0 equals to 1, a0 square equal to 1. Okay, and from n equals to 1 to infinity, half into the sum of an, we have found out already 0, and half into sum of bn whole square. So from here we can write bn square plus b2 square, expand this term, and we found that it is equals to 2 by 7. So it is matching with option 3. Option 3 is the correct option. Question number 7. Let fx be a function such that 0 to infinity f of x e to the power minus beta x dx equal to root power 2 beta to the power 3 by 2 plus beta by beta square plus pi square. Then the value of f of 1 is, so this is the integration, this is the thing we have been given in the question. Taking inverse Laplace transform on both sides, So inverse Laplace, this is basically Laplace transformation. So if taking inverse transformation, this integration sign will remove. So f of x equal to L inverse of this and L inverse of this. Now for finding out the value of these two things, we need to know something, the formulas. L of t to the power n equals to n factorial base 2 to the power n plus 1. Therefore, L of t to the power half equals to 3 by 2 by s to the power 3 by 2. Okay. So we cannot write factorial, so we are writing this like beta integral. Gamma integration, I think. So half gamma half by into 1 plus is still about 3 by 2. Now gamma half equals to root pi by root pi, and this is equals to root pi by 2 into 1 by s to the power 3 by 2, and L inverse of s by s square plus a square equals to cos ax. So these are looking like this. So L inverse of this can be written as 3 to the power half minus x to the power half, and this thing can be written as cos pi x. Now you have to find out f at x equal to 1. So putting x equal to 1, you get 1 minus 1 equals to 0, and it is matching with option 1. Option 1 is the correct option. Moving to question number 8, the value of the integral minus infinity plus infinity dx by x square plus a square into x square plus b square is. Okay, so how to solve this question? What is your answer? Okay, I equals to minus 1 to minus infinity plus infinity, this is we are given. So what we are doing is just separating it. So one extra, 1 by b square minus a square will term will be multiplied here. Okay, now you can see that basically these two integrations are very similar. So if you calculate one integration, then you can write the value of the integration of the other one. So let's, f of z equals to 1 by z square plus a square. So we are approaching, we are taking up the technique of complex integration so that we get this integration very easy. So f of z equals to 1 by z square plus a square means 1 by z plus a into z minus a. And we are taking this type of contour. So you are very familiar with this contour. So only the ratio, only the pose or something which are lying above the axis, x-axis, will contribute, and the pose which are lying below the contour, below this x-axis, will not contribute. So from here we are getting two poles, z equal to plus minus a. So only plus a, ia, plus minus ia. So only z equals to plus ia is lying above x-axis. So residue at z equals to plus pi a, plus ia is equals to 1 by 2ia, but z equals to minus ia lies outside the contour. Therefore, the value of this integration along this curve C equals to pi by a. So basically, this curve C, contour integration around this curve C, can be written as minus infinity plus infinity. You have done it. I have explained these things in the previous set videos, most probably in set 28, where I have discussed 10 problems from complex analysis, so you can check that out. Okay, so we are getting pi by a. So when a was there, we are getting pi by a. So when a will be replaced by b, so the result will be pi by b. Therefore, I equals to 1 by b square minus a square into pi by a minus pi by b, and it is equals to pi by ab into b plus a. So it is matching with option 4. Option 4 is the correct option. Moving to question number 9, let vi be the ith component of a vector field B which has zero divergence. If del j equals to del by del xj, the expression then a comma will be there. The expression for epsilon ij k epsilon lmk delta j delta l vm is equal to. So this is also a good question. So epsilon ij k into epsilon lmk equals to delta I L delta J M minus, now interchangeable with that. So delta I M M into delta K into delta J L. K is common, so K is not appearing here. So this is the formula you need to remember to solve this problem. And we are given the divergence is 0, means del I V I is 0. Okay. So we have to calculate the first term and the second term. The first term is this. It is operating on this term, delta j delta l vm. So we are applying this first term on delta j delta l vm. So firstly, what we are doing, we are putting I equals to l and j equals to m. So I equals to l and j equals to m, so this term conical delta will be 1. So delta j, and in place of l we have put I, so delta del I, and in place of m we put j, so ej. Now these are basically partial integration, so we can interchange the terms. So delta I del j vj, and it is given divergence is 0, so this term is 0. Second term, delta im delta jl, and this term, so we are putting I equals to m and j equals to l. So what we have to put can be decided from here. If you put I equals to m and j equals to l, then these two terms will be 1. Okay, so delta j bi, and equal to delta j square bi. Therefore epsilon I j k epsilon l m k equals to minus delta j square bi, because the minus sign is there, and it is matching with option 2. Option 2 is the correct option. In the last question of this set, given f equals to r cross v, where b equals to b naught into I plus j plus k is a constant vector and r cap is the position vector, the value of closed integral f dot dr, where c is a circle of unit radius centered the origin is. So this is the situation. So centered the origin and the unit circle. So from Stokes theorem we know that closed integral c f dot dr equals to curl of f dot in ds. F is given, so we just put the value of f, and we are taking up polar coordinates to make our calculation very easy. So the area element can be written as r dr d theta, and the limit will be here 0 to 1, and the theta value will be 0 to 2 pi. So r cross b, so you have to find out the cross product. So we are just finding out the cross product and getting these things. And what else we need to find out? We have to find out this stuff. So once r cross b is determined, so we have to find out the curl. So curl of this r cross b is equals to minus 2 v naught into I cap plus j cap plus k cap. So close integral f dot dr equals to minus 2 v naught 0 to 1 r dr into 0 to 2 pi d theta. Okay, look here, I cap plus j cap plus k cap is there, and a k cap was there. So dot, when you take dot product, so only k term will contribute. So minus 2 b naught and k dot into k dot equal to 1, so minus 2 b naught is here. Now taking the integrations, we see it is equals to minus 2 b naught pi, and it is matching with option 3, and this is the end. So I have tried my best to provide the solutions in great detail. Irrespective of this, if you have any doubts, confusions or queries, you can comment down below. I will try my best to clarify them all, and any kind of suggestions are always welcome. So this is all for today, guys. If you find this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, and if you are a new visitor of this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so that you never miss any update. Keep sharing, keep loving, and keep exploring the wonders of physics. And finally, thanks for watching.